We saw a video where five people, let's say A, B, C, D and E, these five girls want to come forward and then take a picture. But they have a small constraint that the picture should be taken with three friends only, which means two people should step back, right? In how many ways can these five girls take a picture, ensuring that the picture comprises of precisely three people? Now, A, B, C, let's say, comes forward, and as we have seen, there are three factorial ways in which they can take a picture, right? And then A, B, D comes forward and C, E steps back, and you have three factorial ways. You are probably worried if there are anything overlapping between this and this. Obviously not. In a picture here, C is included. In a picture here, D is included and C is not there. Although A, B is definitely there here and here, right? These are obviously different pictures. So you have 6 here and 6 here. Now let's try enumerating more. ABC, ABD, and then there are no more options with AB. Well, there is another one, which is ABE. Again, three factorial ways in which you can make these three people take all possible pictures. And you're done. You cannot have AB standing in the pictures anymore because you have exhausted all possibilities with AB included. Now next. What is the immediate next possibility? Let me think. So maybe BC? BC and A is already included. So I'll start with BCD. Three factorial ways. BCE. Three factorial ways. With AB we had three possibilities and each possibility had three factorial ways. With BC we have only two because we are excluding the possibility with BC included, including A, right? Because it is exhausted already. Now AB is done, BC is done, BC along with D, BC along with E exhausts all possibilities. Now let me move on to, let's say, AD. A and D along with B. Now that's exhausted here, as you can see. So this possibility should not be considered. AD along with, let's say, C. Is that over? No, it's not over. So three factorial permutations. AD along with B is over. AD along with C just got over. AD along with E. Three factorial permutations. Right? And that ends all possibilities with AD. How about AE? AE with D is over. AE with B is over. AE with C is not over, as you can see. So AE with C and AE with that's it. AE with D is over. AE with C just got over. AE with B is over. This is three factorial ways. Done. Now, next. Let me think of different ways of having this. One nice way to exhaust everything is to go in ascending order. Right? Okay. So let me start with C. C, D, E. Three factorial ways. Correct? The last possibility that we are missing here is D, B and E. Again, three factorial ways. As you can see, A, B, C, A, B, D, A, B, E, B, C, D, B, C, E, A, D, C, A, D, E, A, E, C, C, D, E and D, E, B are all the possible ways in which three people can step forward. They are precisely 10 in number. And each of them can take pictures in 6 ways. So 10 of them, each of them with 6 ways, is going to be 60 ways. What did we just show? We showed that number of ways in which 5 people can decide to take pictures with 3 in each frame. All possible ways is going to be precisely 60 ways.